Okay, thanks for tuning in. I'm going to try to give you a better explanation of my injury, which is complete rupture of the superior peroneal retinaculum and thus a tearing also of the peroneal tendons. So this is just a quick little diagram I whipped up to give you a better visual. This right here represents my right leg into my right foot. This would be the heel, the arch, and then down towards my toes. So the right leg, right ankle, right foot. The white wires. The white wires represent the peroneal tendons. They look like shoelaces when you see the surgical photographs. So the white wires represent the peroneal tendons, the peroneus longus and the peroneus brevis. This nut represents the right ankle bone. That is, if you take your hand and palpate or feel down your right ankle, the outside of the ankle, that is called the lateral malleolus. So that's what this represents. It's kind of a bony prominence on the outside of your right ankle. And then the duct tape here is going to represent the connective tissue. Okay, so connective tissue, the bony prominence, the right ankle, and then the peroneal tendons. So what happened in my particular injury? These tendons should move rather freely, even though they're secured, but they have ability to move. Say, for example, you were going to stand up on your toes. Well, they would shorten and they would slide up and down and straighten out. Let's say you wanted to lift your toes towards your knees. Well, they're going to move in a certain way that allows movement of those tendons along with the musculature. But in my particular case, what happened with my injury, and thus why I'm going into surgery, is the connective tissue here, the superior peroneal retinaculum. This particular tissue ripped, and that was the snap and the pop that I heard when I sustained my injury. And what happened was, since I no longer had the connective tissue and it happened to rip down through here, my tendons were no longer secure, and what happens is they flipped over. They actually were no longer fitting in the proper groove, and they flipped over the lateral malleolus. Now, in that video that I show the night before my surgery, where I'm in the bathroom at the bathtub, that's the night before I go into surgery, you see me grabbing on to obviously my ankle, even though it's 3 weeks, is still a little bit swollen, but I'm grabbing the tendons and I'm moving them back and forth over my ankle, and that's not anatomically correct. That should not be happening. So, but that's what I'm demonstrating in that video, where I'm moving those tendons back and forth because the connective tissue is no longer there to hold them in support. And when I came over the malleolus, I actually, this bony prominence here, on one of the other videos that I have from the surgery, you can see it's kind of jagged and sharp. So she had to actually grind that part of the bone down to smooth it out, but that's what cut into my tendons and had them fray in the process of coming over my ankle. So she's got to take those tendons, put them back behind the lateral malleolus. There's a groove for them to fit in. She's got to grind down this bone and smooth it out so it's not sharp anymore. And then when she gets those tendons in place, she's got to take that connective tissue and stitch and repair all that up. And then still allow for those tendons to move freely, because they have to be able to move. And then hopefully with time, recovery, and natural biology, my tissue will heal, you know, all the way back up, but this is the primary zone. it'll heal back up, and I should hopefully have complete and utter recovery of that tissue and functionality out of my ankle. That's the idea. Just wanted to give you a better example of it.